Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. You know, a lot of kids have the experience of riding a bike, and I have a bike lying on its side so we can take a closer look at the science that's involved in one specific part of the bike. So when I start the tire spinning, we want to take a closer look at what stops the bike, the brake. We're going to zoom in so you can take a closer look at what's going on and the science that's happening. What you should take a closer look at is right here. This little pad is the brake, and this silver part is the tire itself. And I'm gonna start the tire spinning and watch what happens when we push the brake down. The tire stops. What science is happening to make the tire stop? The bike stopped because of friction. Through science, we've discovered that friction is a force. You can experience the force of friction just by rubbing your hands together. Push them together and rub, and you can feel the force of friction heating up your hands. But we don't just have friction working on our hands. All of us experience the force of friction when we walk around every day. You know, the one thing we have in common is that we wear shoes. But a lot of people don't take the time to stop and look at the bottom of their shoes. And when you look at the bottom of your shoes, you find that science is actually at work. More specifically, the force of friction is at work on the bottom of our shoes. We've zoomed in to take a closer look at the bottom of our shoes, and what do we find? Well, we find that we see all these different patterns of lines, and they look different on every shoe. So what's their purpose? Well, the purpose of these lines and these patterns is to stop the shoe from moving, just like the wheel stopped with our brake. So the bottom of our shoes actually uses the force of friction. And the cool part is that we can measure that force of friction with some really neat demonstrations. We can measure the force of friction using the spring scale. And friction is measured in the units of newtons, named after Isaac Newton. So all we need is this shoe. We have a piece of carpet and a piece of ice, and we're going to see where there's more friction. When I drag the shoe across the carpet, will there be more friction when I drag the shoe across the carpet or when I drag the shoe across the ice? What do you think's going to happen? Well, let's take a look. So we've zoomed in so you have a better chance of trying to see our spring scale, and we're gonna see how many newtons it takes to move our shoe across the carpet. Here we go. I'm gonna start dragging my shoe. You may not be able to see this, but it's reading just over half a newton to move my shoe across the carpet. That's friction at work. Now we're gonna move our shoe over to our ice, and what do you think is gonna happen? Is there gonna be as much friction? How many newtons will it take to move my shoe on the ice? Here we go. So we have our shoe moving, and it's registering just less than half a newton. The carpet was a little bit more than half a newton. The ice was a little bit less than half a newton. Which one has more friction? Even if we didn't have a spring scale to measure newtons, we still can look at the friction. I have one shoe on ice and one shoe on carpet. I'm just going to push and see how far the shoe moves. You can see that shoe slides, same amount of push. It doesn't really go anywhere. Why? Because there's more friction at work on the carpet than there is on the ice. Do you know, all this talk about the force of friction at work in our feet has me wondering. I wonder if we could come up with a design challenge. I wonder if we could design our own pattern of lines for the bottom of our shoes and take a closer look at the force of friction that's at work. It sounds like a great design challenge. If you're interested in that design challenge, take a look at our Force of Friction in Our Feet Part 2. So the next time you're out riding your bike or even just walking along the street, stop and think about the force of friction that's at work all around you. Because sometimes you just have to stop and try and wonder why. Thanks for watching.